Hello friends, welcome to ASP.NET MVC code snippet, and in this video we are going to learn how to upload a file using strongly typed helper. So basically, since I mentioned it is strongly typed helper, so we are going to create proper model for it and we will observe what will be the property data type, as well as we will see the validation part. And one more thing we are going to study is that how to assign unique name to your uploaded file. So let us see this part practically. So as you can see here, I already created an MVC project named as file upload demo. There is one home controller, okay, and in my home controller I added two action methods. First one is index method, which will render a view, whereas this save method will save the content posted by our index method. Okay, now here I created one folder also for uploaded, to store the content of uploaded files. So basically what we are going to do, whatever file uploaded by the user, we will store in this folder. Okay, I created a view also. And the most important thing, as I mentioned, we are going to create a strongly typed helper, and we know that whenever we create a strongly typed helper, it is binded to our model. So let us observe the property of a model and the data type of a property. So here I already created one product model. I added data annotations also, okay, because as I told you, we are going to see the validation part. So in my product model, there is name of product, okay, and I'm going to upload the image for the product. So as you can see here, I created image property, and the data type of your property is HTTP posted file base. Remember this thing, whenever you are going to upload a property, or sorry, upload a file directly into your model property, in that case your property type will be what? HTTP posted file base. And here I'm going to store the name of my image file. So here I'm explaining it, this part from database point of view. So whenever you are going to save a record of a product in a database, what you will do? You will save a name of image, and image will get stored in this folder. Okay, so image gets stored in this uploaded file. So we are not going to store the image in the database because it acquires lots of space. So the best idea is what? You will store the image in your folder structure, whereas your database will contain the name of your image file. Okay, and while retrieving, we know the path of our file, and already name is stored in our database. So from that we can load our image on our web page. Okay, so I hope you understand this. And if you observe here, I use data annotation also. Suppose you want to put a compulsion that users should select a file, so the data annotation or validation attribute for this is required. Okay, suppose you want to allow user to select image file only, in that case you can go for file extensions, and we already studied this attribute while studying the validation data annotation. So by default this data annotation will work for images only. Suppose you want to change the extension, in that case you can specify the extension argument. Okay, and here you have to specify the file types if it is other than image. So I hope you understand this. So by default, as I told you, it works for images, PNG image, JPG image, etc., etc. Now let us switch to our controller. As I told you, I already created this two action method. So index action method will render a view, whereas this save action method will upload your file, and as well as it will pass your data forward to your data access layer. So here we will focus on how to generate a unique name for your file and how to upload a file in this uploaded file folder. Okay, so let us switch to our view. I just completed a basic code for my view. So as you can see here, there is a model declaration. Since we are going to create a strongly typed view and we are going to use a strongly typed helper, so I should have a model declaration. Okay, using form helper I created this HTML form. Okay, and this text box is created for name, and one button but submit button is added to it. Okay, now let us see the helper for file upload. So let me create one div. Let us apply form dash group CSS class, bootstrap class. Then let us specify the label, say upload image. Now here for strongly typed helper for your image upload, what trick is used? Basically your text box is used for that. Okay, you're going to use text box for helper. Okay, specify your HTTP posted file base property. Remember this thing, it should be of type HTTP posted file base only. Okay, that we created in our model. And here what trick you will use, while specifying this additional HTML attribute, you will specify type is equal to file. Okay, all of you know that what is the HTML tag for file upload? Input type is equal to file. Okay, so what we did, we used text box for helper and we just set this extra attribute type to file. Let me apply the CSS class also. So class is equal to form dash control. Okay, now let us add validation message for helper. So HTML dot validation message for m goes to m dot image. Okay, now we're done with this part. Now the next important thing, we are going to apply both client side validation and server side validation also. Okay, so for server side validation, we already applied this validation attribute, and to apply the same attribute for our client side validation, what we have to do, we have to install the package for unobtrusive validation. Okay, and I already installed it. You have to go to package manager console, and as you can see here, this is the command to install unobtrusive validation. Okay, microsoft.jquery.unobtrusive.validation. So I already installed it, and this two file gets included in our script folder, which is validate.js and another one is validate.unobtrusive.js. Okay, I just drag and drop it here. Now these two files requires the reference of our jQuery file, main jQuery file. Okay, and the reference of jQuery file is added in layout view. That's why I created a section here, and then after, below the reference of my jQuery file, as you can see here, I render the validation section. Okay, and I specify this false attribute, false argument, because not my all the view will have this section. So to avoid the error, I specify this false argument. Okay, and this validation section is created here. Okay, now the most important thing, so whenever you are going to upload file, you have to specify the encryption type attribute of your form. Okay, so how will you set it? Definitely we have to use the anonymous class to set an extra attribute, as we did here for our text box. Okay, extra HTML attributes are set in this form. So let us see the overload that we need to use. So we have to use this overload because last argument, the fourth argument, is HTML attribute. Okay, now we want to post to this save action method. Okay, so let us specify the action method name save. My controller is home controller, then my posting method is post, and my HTML attribute is in the form of anonymous class. So my attribute name is enc type is equal to multipart slash form dash data. So this is very important part. If you do not specify this, your file will never upload. Okay, so I hope you understand this. Again, I did one more thing. In my site.css file, I created this CSS class, that is field dash validation dash error, because whenever there is an error, what happened? this validation summary apply, sorry, this validation message will apply this field dash validation dot dash error class. Okay, and I just want to display that error messages in red color, so that's why I specify the color red, otherwise it will appear in normal black color. So just to avoid this, I added this CSS, and the reference of this site.css file is already there in my layout view, as you can see here. Look at here. Okay, so we're done with our view. Okay, we already completed our model. The CSS and rest of the part is complete. And again, I'll repeat, this is very important thing. You have to set this attribute of a form if you are going to upload a file. Otherwise, your file will never upload. Now, let us write a code of a controller. Okay. So here, what we will do, first of all, we will check, since we are performing the complex model binding. Okay, what we did, we are collecting directly an entire model in our action method. So this is nothing but a complex model binding. So what we will do, we'll first of all check whether our model is valid or not. So using model state dot is valid property. Okay, so if it is valid, what I want to do, I want to check whether my image has a file or not. Okay, because since we put a client side validation, there might be a possibility that somebody has do not selected the file to upload. So to be on a safer side, we are going to check if model.image is not equal to null or not. If it is not equal to null, then only we are going to upload a file. Okay, and one more thing here, I already use this namespace for models, that is file upload dot file upload demo dot models. Okay, then only you can use this model, as well as we are going to take a help of our IO namespace. So that namespace is also used already. So these two namespaces are required. Okay, one is namespace of our model and the another one is IO namespace. Now, as I told you, we are going to create unique name for our uploaded file, because many times what happens, if this page is requested by more than, say, simultaneously accessed by many users, okay, and many users are uploading a file at the same time, and it might be a case that name of the image files can be same uploaded by the user. So to avoid this, what we are going to do, we are going to create a unique name using timestamp. Okay, so here I'll say string image name is equal to, so here I'll say, I'll just create my own name, so product underscore plus, so we want to assign the current date timestamp, so here I'll say date time dot now dot to string, say dd. For month, I'll use capital M is used. For year, small y is used. Then for 12-hour clock, I'll use HH. For minutes, MM. Seconds, SS. And triple F for milliseconds. Okay. Now, we want extension of a file also. So how will you get it? So there is a path class in our IO namespace. And it has a method, get extension. Okay, so to this get extension, you have to provide the HTTP posted file base property, and it has a file name property. Okay, so what this file name property contains, the name of uploaded file, but what we want, we just want an extension of my file, because we are creating a file name ourselves. Suppose you want to use that file name, you can directly use it. So you have to say model.image.filename. Okay, so in this way also you can get a file name. So I'll just put that code here. So string original file name. How will you get original file name? So you have to say model.image, which is nothing but our HTTP posted file base property, dot file name. That's it. So suppose you want to use this, you can use this. Here I am going to create a unique name for file. Now, the next step is to save a file in this created folder, uploaded files folder. Okay. So for that, what you have to use? Again, there is a method of this HTTP posted file base property, that is save as. Okay. So this save as method, we have to provide this path. Okay, so basically we can get this path using server.mappath. So I'll say server.mappath. Now since we have to specify the root directory path, so /, uploaded files. Okay, and then after I have to specify the image name. So again, to be on safer side, I'm going to use path.combine method. So path.combine, so it will combine the path. So this is my root path, and then after I'll specify my file name, which is image name. Okay, now this part get completed. If you are not going to use path.combine, what you have to say? server.mappath /, uploaded file /, then image name. Okay, so if you are combining more than two variables using for the path, it is better to use path.combine. Okay, now this part get, this particular statement will save your file, and what we are going to do, we are just going to display a message to the user that whether file is saved or not. So for that, I am going to use viewBack. So let us say viewBack.status is equal to file uploaded. Okay, and if there are any errors, what we will say, viewBack dot status is equal to error in uploading, and what we will do, we will redirect to same view, that is index view. But since our method name and view name is different, so I have to specify the view name explicitly. Now let me create a place for displaying this viewBack message. So what we will do, we will display it here below our form. So here, first of all, I'll check whether, because initially when we run this index view, definitely viewBack do not have any content. Okay, so let us check whether this status is null or not. If it is not equal to null, then only we are going to create a place for this. I hope you understand this. Okay, so span, then class is equal to, so instead of, okay, say class is equal to alerts. So these are again bootstrap classes, alert info. Okay, we are going to display the info, and we are going to display the message in our viewBack. Okay, so see, initially when our view get executed, at that time the status will be null, but when this view get displayed after execution of this save method, it will have the value. That's why I check this, otherwise this span get displayed always. Okay, so we completed with this part. Now the next thing is to test it, so let us execute it. So as you can see here, the view is rendered. Okay, so let us check against the validation first. See, empty field validations are exactly working properly. Now let us check for the other than text file, other than image file. See, here it is showing you that select image only. Now let me add a product name, say test. Okay, now let me select the image. Okay, and let us say submit. Okay, I think there is an error in uploading, so let us check that. So let us debug it and we'll check the output. Okay, let me submit it. Okay, now as you can see here, look at here, it is showing model state is valid false. Okay, let me check it. Just expand this result view, then values, and here there is an error. What is the error? It is showing select image only. Basically, we specified the image only, but there is a problem in our file extension validation attribute. Basically, you have to create your own validation attribute. While studying a validation annotation, at that time also we faced this problem. So this inbuilt validation file extension validation do not work properly. You will create it for yourself. Okay, so for time being, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to remove this part. Okay, in upcoming videos I'll definitely try to upload that part. Okay, now it is fine. So let us run this again, and again we will check the output. Say test. Let me select this, say submit. Okay, now here I am doing step over, so image is not equal to null. Okay, so here my image name get created and it is product and timestamp get attached. Okay, now it will save the image and the status get also get display. Okay, basically again what is happening, we should put this part in the else. Viewback.status is equal to error in file uploading, it should appear in the else part. Okay, so definitely we are going to get the error message, but actually our image is uploaded. So let us verify this. And let me make that change. First of all, here I should put this part in the else, right? Okay, now here what you can do, just right click over here and say open folder in file explorer. Look at here, this get stored in our folder. Okay, so I hope you understand this tutorial, how to upload a file. Okay, in upcoming videos I'll definitely try to upload a video related to the validation part. So thank you. And one more thing is remaining, actually I didn't assign the created image to our model property. So what I have to do, model dot image file name, we already created that property in our product model, which is nothing but our img name. Or you can directly say model.image file name is equal to, in this way also, and this image file name will get stored in your database. So thank you so much.